Mercy. Oh my god. Oh my god. My penis on my job. My penis on my job. Oh god.
I am about to share with you something very graphic, disturbing and triggering to anyone who has a conscience. I will not show you any graphics, but I will expose you to something that you won't believe to be true. This is a sick world that we live in, and it's time to stand up for what's right and save the children. The Queen Maria Catholic Nursery in the southwest German village of Tenenbronn told parents it was setting up a safe room for children to embark on a journey to their bodies under adult supervision, subject to parental consent. Yes, you heard it right. Daycares in Germany are promoting the use of sexual exploration rooms, where young children between the ages of 2 and 5 years old are encouraged to touch themselves and engage in sexual games with other children. The nursery claims to offer children freedom to try out childish sexuality, insisting that masturbation is something normal and that the establishment considers allowing sexual self-gratification on its premises to be of great importance. In another daycare center in the state, this time in the town of Rheinberg, doctor games are prepared in adjoining rooms for children to explore the bodies of others. The rules, issued by the nursery, encourage children to pick those they wish to explore and urge them to do so carefully. The local government does not appear to be fazed by the practice. When asked about the idea of children being encouraged to masturbate and touch each other sexually, the state's children's ministry, led by Green Josephine Paul, claimed that sexual behavior by children could not be prevented and insisted it had no plans to contact the daycare centers within its remit to discuss the matter. Do you see what is happening? They are normalizing pedophilia. If you think this is normal, your ass needs to be canceled right along with them. This is not normal. This is sick, evil, and psychotic behavior. Green Josephine Paul is a sick individual and needs to be called out and canceled for their actions. It seems that not many people are bothered by this because this article was released in August and it hasn't gained enough attention. What are you going to do to take control and end this madness? If you have a voice, use it. We must take control and put an end to this sick behavior. It's only a matter of time before they try this in America. Wake up, people. Please share this video and follow for more.
I feel like I have a duty to warn parents about something. They're coming for your children. They want your kids to be indoctrinated into far-left voters who believe anything the media feeds them. And a lot of parents don't even realize it's happening. Here's the most recent example. This is the Paw Patrol spinoff called Rubble and Crew. Sounds like no big deal, right? So in this new Paw Patrol spinoff, they've got a new non-binary character. Look at the socks and shoes. This was intentional, and the writer admitted it. Yeah, those were shoes and socks in the trans pride colors. Now you might be asking, who was the writer? The writer's somebody named Lynn Zamir, who runs a YouTube channel called Queer Kid Stuff. And it's as bad as it sounds. They indoctrinate kids and provide quote-unquote LGBTQ+ resources for them. These are the types of people spending time alone with your child, indoctrinating them into this woke mass hysteria. If you don't want people like this indoctrinating your kids and reaching the inside of your home with their woke far-left hysteria, it's time to turn the TV off, guys. Rebel and Crew isn't alone. Netflix did the same thing. So did Transformers. So did Blue's Clues. They want to sexualize your kids. This is a grooming pipeline. It starts here with these subtle references in TV shows your kids get indoctrinated with, then they head off to public school where their teacher indoctrinates them further, and before you know it, you have a child that is fully indoctrinated into the woke cult. You know now, so you can stop it. Turn the TV off.
going on right now in China of older women getting face transplants. Now, I'm sure this is not new technology, and we've had the ability to probably do this for several years, and it's now just going mainstream. But my only question is where are they getting these faces from? Because if you ask me, this looks like a child's face. And we know how big the human trafficking problem is, not just in our country, but internationally. So I dare to ask the question, where are they getting children's faces from? It's crazy.
So I just got home from watching The Sound of Freedom, and I have been an emotional wreck. You have to watch that film. You have to go watch that film. I am just appalled at what's been shed to light during this film. And how is this still happening? How are we still letting this happen? Like, with the technology and the manpower that we have now, how is this still happening? How is this allowed to happen to our children? Why are people not doing anything about it? Why is this film being, like, they're trying to stop this film from being seen? Why? Why? Why are we as Americans, or as just humans, not asking these questions? Why are we not fighting back? Why are we not helping this cause? Like, this is our children. This is our children. How are we not, like, I wish that I, like, it makes me want to just go undercover and take these people down. Like, Mel Gibson, a huge celebrity, is backing this financially. An established producer has created The Sound of Freedom. Big time actors are in this show, and you're telling me that it's taken 5 years for this to hit theaters? Netflix, Amazon, Hulu, Disney Plus, of course Disney Plus, is not streaming it? How dare you? How dare you people stop this from being seen? Like, what is wrong with us? Are we such sheep that we just turn a blind eye to things like this? What is wrong with us? What is wrong with us? These are children, helpless children. Like, we have got to start doing our job. Wake up, people. Like, this is happening right now, today, when we were leaving the theaters, even tonight. This lady came up to me and my sister and said, hey, look, you guys need to check your vehicles, because we just came outside and there was a zip tie on my door handle. Please be aware. Be vigilant. Check your vehicles. We have got to be more aware of this stuff. We have got to protect our children. Like, we have got to stop supporting Disney. Stop supporting Netflix. Stop supporting all these stupid big-time people that aren't truly looking after us. Truly looking after our people. They're not telling us the truth. They're hiding stuff. And now that someone's actually stepping up and trying to shed light on something, they're trying to shut it off. They're trying to stop us from seeing the truth. Don't be those people. Don't be those people. Spread the word. Watch Sound of Freedom.
Hi friends, welcome to Queer Kid Stuff. I'm Linz,
and I'm Teddy.
And this is my best stuff friend, Teddy. And this is Teddy's Book Club, where we're reading LGBTQ+ picture books with you all every Saturday morning. This week, we are reading a book called What's an Abortion Anyway?
Linz, what is an abortion anyway?
Well, we're just gonna have to find out in the book, Teddy. This is What's an Abortion Anyway by Carly Maines and Emulsify. And I'm really excited to read this book because I don't think there are any other picture books that talk about what an abortion is. And it's really important idea to understand right now. Isn't it, Teddy?
Yeah, that's right.
Sing along with me at home, all right? If you're a drag queen and you know it, blow a kiss. If you're a drag queen and you know it, blow a kiss. If you're a drag queen and you know it, and you really want to show, if you're a drag queen and you know it, blow a kiss. All right, the next one is strike a pose, okay? If you're a drag queen and you know it, strike a pose. If you're a drag queen and you know it, strike a pose. If you're a drag queen and you know it, and you really want to show, if you're a drag queen and you know it, strike a pose. Nice poses, everyone. All right, the next one is say ta-da. If you're a drag queen and you know it, say ta-da, ta-da!
I was 13. I had my first testosterone injection. It's caused permanent changes to my body. My voice will forever be deeper, my jawline sharper, my nose longer, my bone structure permanently masculinized, my Adam's apple more prominent, my fertility unknown. I look in the mirror sometimes, and I feel like a monster. I had a double mastectomy at 15. They tested my amputated breast for cancer. And I was cancer-free, of course. I was perfectly healthy. There was nothing wrong with my still-developing body, or my breasts, other than that, as an insecure teenage girl, I felt awkward about it. After my breasts were taken away from me, the tissue was incinerated. Before I was able to legally drive, I had a huge part of my future womanhood taken from me. I will never be able to breastfeed. I struggle to look at myself in the mirror at times. I still struggle to this day with sexual dysfunction. And I have massive scars across my chest. And the skin grafts that they took of my nipples are weeping fluid today. And they were grafted into a more masculine positioning, they said. After surgery, my grades in school plummeted. Everything that I went through did nothing to address my underlying mental health issues that I had. And my doctors, with their theories on gender, thought that all my problems would go away as soon as I was surgically transformed into something that vaguely resembled a boy. Their theories were wrong. The drugs and surgeries changed my body, but they did not and could not change the basic reality that I am and forever will be a female.
I saw something from Canada that I want to play for you. It is an ad that it's an ad for a retail brand in Canada that we don't have here. Listen. So this is an ad called All Is Beauty.
I seek help to end my life with all the pain.
It is a campaign in support of medically assisted suicide. There is now a way to take your life back. From early adopting Switzerland to latest to the table Australia, more and more countries are legalizing the practice of euthanasia. It's now available to over 280 million people in 11 countries around the world. It was offered to my mother, who recently and gratefully used Canada's legislation to orchestrate her own wise demise. If we don't claim the design of our own death, it is likely someone else will. So the government started arguing this, that people who were nearing the end of their life and had a fatal disease. The next was someone with mental illness. Now, wait a minute. Mental illness? Now they're crossing the Holy Grail in Canada. The Canadian Pediatric Society, CPS, has just written Medical Assistance in Dying, a Pediatric Perspective, ensuring that newborns, children, and youth receive the highest possible standard of care as they are dying. And dying is a privilege and a responsibility for physicians and allied professionals, bringing about a thoughtful, respectful, and personal approach to everyday end-of-life situations is an essential and evolving duty of care. And process should meet each patient and family's unique social, cultural, and spiritual needs. Oh, so it's okay to kill children in Canada as long as we meet their cultural and social and spiritual needs. The Canadian Pediatric Society refers to the children it aims to mercy kill as mature minors. Mature minors. In other words, you have to have enough sense of self and request that someone kills you. That makes you eligible. However, what about those who are born without the ability to understand things? Are they really living their highest life? If you look at what is being pushed all over our society, you will see names like Jane Goodall, who said, are all of our problems on Earth, all of our problems on Earth with climate change would be solved if the population of Earth was reduced by 90%. By the way, she's an agenda contributor to the World Economic Forum. So to kill 90% of the population, that would, that'd be hard. And it'd make the Nazis and the Soviets and the Chinese combined look like rookies.
Little baby, don't you cry, everything's gonna be alright. Stiffing at a bullet bump, little lady, I told ya, daddy's here to hold ya through the night. I know mommy's not here right now and we don't know why. We feel how we feel inside, it may seem a little crazy.